But one sec, this is an extension, right?
No.
This is native.
That's native.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you 100% sure?
I'm 100% sure. I never installed it.
Cool. So today we've got a slightly different format for What's in My Raycast. We've got Bruno here, our video producer at Raycast. He's in person, so we thought, why not do a in-person What's in My Raycast? And I'm particularly excited about this one because he knows exactly what's in my Raycast because of all the videos we've done, but I have no idea what's in his. So why don't you show us what's in your Raycast?
All right, let's do it. All right, so the first thing that I use Raycast for when I'm recording my screen, which I record yours often, so that you guys can watch it in like a smaller display, like an iPhone or something, we like change the display settings, right? And you can do this by going to system settings and, you know, display settings, something like that, and changing it here. But there is an extension in Raycast that does it automatically. So it's called Display Placer. And if I just load the preset number one, you can see that my screen is big now. And Raycast moved to a weird place. But, you know, we can just reset the position like this, right? And he centers back.
Yeah, I love that little reset command, actually. Yeah. I use that all the time.
I use that a lot, yeah. In general, I use Raycast the most as a launcher, right? So to launch applications. It's just that much faster than Spotlight. I don't know. I haven't measured it, but it just feels a lot snappier than Spotlight.
Definitely.
To launch stuff. So that's what I use it for. And that's what, you know, got me hooked from the beginning. And I usually just press my hotkey and
command space.
No, it's not command space.
Oh, is it not?
Yeah, it's option space.
Okay.
See, because I used to use Photoshop a lot. I don't anymore as much. But in Photoshop, when you press command space, it's a shortcut to zoom in.
Oh, okay.
So you press command space and the cursor becomes a magnifying glass. So what would happen is before I knew Raycast, I would press command space in Photoshop. That's after I came from Windows, actually. I would press command space and Spotlight would show up and it would annoy me like so much. And then I configured Spotlight to be option space.
And that became your muscle memory.
Yeah.
Right.
Because... And before Raycast. So when I downloaded Raycast, it was like default replacing Spotlight already.
Right.
Okay, so I press option space and I usually just type for the application that I want to open. I do have some shortcuts, right? So for DaVinci Resolve, I have Control Shift D and I try to make them hard to press.
Okay.
Because you see, what you do is you have them for as like option in a letter.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
I have two problems with that. So one is when you work with creative production applications, usually they take a lot to open. So I do not want to open them like unintentionally.
Oh, I see. Yeah. I had a similar feeling when I was editing more in the past with Final Cut Pro.
Yeah.
It's like, it takes like 3 minutes.
It takes a long time. But the other reason why I try to make them hard is because these applications, right, like DaVinci Resolve, have a bunch of hotkeys already.
Yeah.
So I like to make them not as common. Most applications in macOS don't use Control. So when I create hotkeys with Control...
It doesn't conflict with shortcuts from an app. And obviously for things like DaVinci Resolve, that is full of shortcuts.
It's full of shortcuts,
the chances of conflict is quite high. But do you use hotkeys for anything else?
So another one that I do often is the Clipboard History. I do Command, Option, Shift, V, and then I get to Clipboard History. And this is like the sound that I used. How do you... Oh, show in Founders.
Come on.
Oh, quick look. Come in, I.
That's the sound.
That's the sound, yeah. What I love about Clipboard History as well is when you get these, like you remember stuff that you pasted.
Yeah.
Often it's like a meme or...
Yeah, definitely.
Or like something funny and you just open it and it like brings you joy.
Mm-hmm. You know, what I'm curious about is as a video producer, right, as a video editor, how do you use Raycast for that specifically, like to help save you time while working?
All right, so this is the... Now I have something that I just thought about.
All right,
and I want to
let's
show
do this.
You. Whenever you're in like a very complex application, a feature of Raycast that's super useful that I was super happy to figure out that it exists is search menu items. What I want to search for is audio scrubbing. DaVinci Resolve, which is that thing that when you scroll through the timeline, you can hear the audio.
So you want to turn that
on? I'm going to turn that off.
Yeah,
because that's annoying. So I'm going to search for audio scrub. you see?
Yeah.
And I just press enter.
Yeah, that's amazing.
And it's like, it turned it on. Like, isn't that?
You see,
like,
this is something that I know about, but I have never used.
I've never used it.
Need to use it.
Because I want to show you, like...
But one sec, look at this. This is an extension, right?
No.
This is native.
That's native.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you 100% sure?
I'm 100% sure. I never installed it. Look how much stuff there is here. There's just a lot of things to do, and you can never remember where they are. It's like the logic is complicated. And also, there's like...
Submenus.
Yes, submenus and stuff. So it's super hard. And when I figured out that you can just search for it in Raycast and just press enter and do it, and it also shows you the actual app hotkeys.
The default shortcuts.
Default, just if I set one,
right?
It also shows it to me. So it's pretty awesome. And so I just turned it off.
Yeah, that's great. That's a great use case, I think. For menus that are so complex, like DaVinci Resolve, Final Cut Pro, whatever.
Photoshop, Logic Pro, any kind of After Effects, any kind of app like this.
Definitely.
There's this one workflow that I do that I think is really cool. It really helps that DaVinci Resolve can work in a text-based way because Raycast is really powerful for text-based things. So the way it works is I get these clips and I put them in a Fusion clip and I move into Fusion and they're represented thing like this node structure. But when I copy the nodes and I just paste them into a text application, you can see that it's just text. And when I copy the text back and I go back to DaVinci Resolve, if I paste it here, I get the same thing back.
Right.
And it works just fine. And whenever you think copying and text, what do you think?
Snippets.
Exactly. Snippets. It's perfect for it. And I actually started using Clipboard History first, right? Because I thought Clipboard History remembers what I copied, so this is going to be super useful. But when I launch Clipboard History, it's like a bunch of random text that I have no idea what this means. I know it's from DaVinci Resolve, and I see like the opening brackets. I know it's probably something that I copied that it's useful, but I don't really know, right? I can't name it.
Yeah.
But when I wanted to name it, I realized that when you go to the command bar and you go save, it becomes a snippet.
Yeah, that's cool. You can save as a snippet directly from there.
Yeah, and then you can add a name. So instead of just having a bunch of random characters, when I open my snippets, I have saved two of these for this video specifically. So this is like the split screen for Thomas and Pedro. And I configured it so it pastes directly into wherever application I am. So when I paste it and I preview it on the screen, I get it back.
Wow, that's amazing. That's really good.
Which is awesome.
Yeah.
I just create the effect once. I save it as a snippet because it's just text.
Yeah.
And then I go through the whole thing and just...
Yeah, that's really good. The fact that you can just paste text into DaVinci Resolve and it renders it as a node, but it understands that as an input. Yeah, it's amazing. Yeah. I think Clipboard History snippets is the perfect use case for it. So what else are you using Raycast for?
Ever since I knew that we were coming to Spain for the offsite thing, I've been trying to learn Spanish a little bit. So I use the translator a lot. I have like Spanish classes remotely with a teacher. So he's talking to me and I want to show him that I know stuff.
Of course.
So I just sneakily open Raycast and I go translate and I can do command P to change it to Spanish. I can just ask it how to say, I don't know, my shower is not hot today. Mi ducha no está caliente hoy. Because that's what happened in my hotel room.
That actually happened.
And I hope they fixed it. But what I also use, I created a quick link for this, is I want to know how to conjugate a verb in Spanish.
Right.
So this is a quick link, conjugar, that I just press tab. I just type a verb like hacer.
Oh, right, and then that opens in a browser.
Yeah, it opens in a browser. Yeah, and
that's just
I know
a quick link. Yeah. That's nice, though. It's a quick link.
Yeah, it's very quick.
Right.
Yeah, with a query. Yeah.
Cool. How about we change gears a little bit and I ask you some spicy questions I have written down here. What is one thing that you don't like about Raycast?
What I don't like about Raycast is you can't use Raycast inside of Raycast. So if I want to add like an emoji here, Control Command Space. Like
gone.
Yeah, it's gone, right? Which is annoying and it's like, you know, it's a deep problem to solve. But when I go back to the snippets, it's still there.
was still there because Raycast creates it as a draft, right?
Which is, you know,
less bad.
I'm like annoyed, but not as annoyed.
But you're also slightly impressed.
Exactly.
So it has impressed. That kind of.
Yeah, there's like it's like a roller coaster. But I realized that if you add a colon, you can search for, you know, emojis.
Yeah, you get an inline emoji.
You can get an inline emoji.
Yeah.
But also, you can't really use clipboard history here, right?
Not yet.
You're not yet.
We're going to find an inline solution for that as well. I think that, yeah, a lot of people don't really like that. It's like, it's but, just because you're relying on Raycast for too many things, right?
Yeah, but yeah, I think it says a lot, right? We want to use Raycast so much that we want to use it within Raycast.
Right, exactly. Yeah. What's something you wish Raycast did?
I wish there was like a no-code way to create an extension.
Oh, yes. That would be very cool.
Because that would be like the next step, right? To convince more people to not just use Raycast, but like build.
Yeah, contribute to the extension platform. Yeah. The extension you use the most?
It's probably LastPass, yeah.
What about an extension that you have, but you never use?
I have a bunch because of the video that we did for designers. So I just installed a bunch of them and I never use them. But one of them is Brew. Right, to install
homebrew, yeah.
Homebrew to install Brew applications because I feel a little bit like a hacker when I do it from the terminal.
Yeah.
So I like that rush.
Yeah.
I don't want to do it.
I get it.
So I don't use it.
What about the extension that blew your mind?
Have you seen Piano Chords, the extension?
I don't think so. Let's have a look.
Look. So search Piano Chord, let's say an A. Mm-hmm. And you get like chords,
That's
A major stuff. It's like with images and stuff.
Can you hear the sound as well or not?
Oh, that would be super fun.
What happens when you press enter?
Yeah, when you press. Oh, it gives you inversions and stuff. It doesn't give you the
cool
sound.
To listen to it as well.
It would be awesome to listen to it. If you play, if you open it on the browser, you can listen to it.
Oh, that's cool. Man, thanks so much for showing me what's in your Raycast, showing everybody here what's in your Raycast.
Thank you for having me in Barcelona.
Exactly.
I've been just messing this studio up. You guys have no idea. Have you broken anything yet?
We've not broken anything yet, but we've made loads of little tweaks in the lighting, set. So make sure to subscribe.
yeah, subscribe. Gotta watch this. And wait.
That is a wrap. Thank you very much.
Yeah.